Hello. Welcome to our YouTube channel. If you are new here, please subscribe. This is another video presentation feature a question on corporation law asked in the 1998 version of the bar exams. The question was, the board of directors of X company, acting on a standing authority of the stockholders to amend the bylaws, amended its bylaws so as to disqualify any of its stockholders who is also a stockholder and director of a competitor from being elected to its board. Why, a stockholder holding sufficient assets to assure him of a seat in the board, filed a petition with the SEC for a declaration of nullity of the amended bylaws. He alleged, among other things, that as a stockholder, he had acquired rights inherent in stock ownership such as the right to vote and be voted upon in the election of directors. Is the stockholder's petition tenable? Notice that the question is again answerable by yes or no. The student is reminded once again the importance of always being responsive to the question. The relevant facts of the problem are as follows. 1. The board of directors amended the corporation's bylaws. 2. The bylaws was amended so as to disqualify a stockholder and director of a competitor from being elected to the board. 3. Y argued that such provision is a nullity since, being a stockholder, he has the right to vote and be voted upon in the election of directors. The question was cleverly framed so that students might think that the question is about stockholders' right, since the main character in the question is Y, who has sufficient assets, presumably shares, in the corporation to earn for himself a seat in the board. It is possible also that others might think that this is about amendment of bylaws since the question started with the exercise of corporate power to amend bylaws and such power was delegated to the board. But the question here is whether the petition of Y was tenable or not, and the petition is about a qualification, or better yet, a disqualification inserted in the bylaws. A quick glance at Section 46 of the revised Corporation Code will give us the clue. A private corporation may provide in its bylaws for F. the directors' or trustees' qualifications, duties and responsibilities. It is clear therefore that it within the right of the corporation to provide such qualifications in the bylaws. Certainly, the disqualification of someone who is also a director of a competitor is definitely reasonable. Thus, while stockholders indeed have right to vote and be voted upon, regardless of the number of shares, this right may be limited by a provision in the bylaws. The problem also did not state any fact that would lead us to conclude that the delegation made by the stockholders to the directors was infirm, hence, we can safely presume such was validly made. The examiner, however, may raise this if he or she wants to improve his score, but this must be made with caution. All things considered, the suggested answer is no. The petition is not tenable because a corporation may provide in its bylaws the qualifications of its directors or trustees. While it is true that any stockholder, regardless of amount of shareholding, may be elected to the board, such right may be qualified through the bylaws. Certainly, prohibiting a director of a competitor to sit in the board is not unreasonable. If at all, Y may look into whether the delegation of the power to amend bylaws was made in accordance with the requirements of the law. Since there was no indication made in the problem, we may presume that same was valid. We hope you learned something useful in this video. Thank you. If you liked this video, please subscribe to our channel and like our Facebook page ECS Notes. You may also comment and share this video to your friends. Have a pleasant day.